One of the key strengths of Logos Bible software is the ability to build powerful and sophisticated searches, and we're going to explore some of these capabilities in this and the next video in the series. The previous video introduced various filters that can be applied to resources to highlight key items of supporting information, and now we're going to see how those can be used to form the basis for searching. You looked at verse 37, where Jesus was identified as the speaker. Right-click on part of his speech and scroll down the right side of the context menu until you see Jesus shown there as the speaker. Select this by clicking it and then choose to search this resource on the left. This finds all places in the Bible where Jesus is identified as the speaker, even when he isn't explicitly named in the text, such as in Matthew 4:4. The same technique can be used to search for addressees. We can even combine them using logical operators such as or and. So you can modify the search to just include those times when Jesus was speaking to the Jews of his time, as previously in the chapter, by using the intersects operator. This specifies that both criteria need to occur in the same place in the text. Then add the second search term. Start with an open curly bracket and then add the identifier addressee. Then to specify these, type Jews. Select the corresponding person label from the drop-down and close the curly brackets. Press Enter to run the search. Alternatively, instead of building the search term manually, you can do it using search templates by selecting the option to search for one person speaking to another person. Enter Jesus in the speaker field and Jews in the time of Jesus in the addressee field and click the search button. To see how searching for propositions from the Propositional Outline filter can be really powerful, right-click Flow in verse 38, and scroll down the context menu until getting to the Propositional Outline entry, which in this case is tagged as a quotation. Search the resource in a similar way as for the speaker label to see all the places in the Bible marked as a quotation. As well as searching for speakers and addressees, we can search for people. So add Jesus to the search string in a similar way as we did before to find all occurrences of Jesus being linked to a particular quotation. As you can see, these can be quickly combined to provide very powerful search capabilities. There are many search options available from the context menu, including searching for other occurrences of the sense of a word. Right-click the word believes in verse 38 and note that it is associated with the sense of trusting in Jesus. Select this and search in this resource to see the different places where this occurs. Scroll down to the results in John 7 to see how different people responded to Jesus. One further powerful search technique is that of searching within milestones, which are used to mark specific locations and resources. For example, the beginning of each verse in the Bible will be marked as a location by a milestone that defines that verse. In the sixth video of this series, we are looking at the word believes in verse 38 and seeing how the underlying Greek term was used. To find all places where the word believes occurs in your library, right-click the word, ensure that the word is selected on the right, and then choose to search all resources on the left. There are a lot of results. If you want to restrict this to only the resources that are discussing this word in articles on John 7:38, add a milestone term to the search string by using the within operator. This finds the first term inside the constraints of the second term. Enter within and then open some curly brackets. Then enter milestone, specify John 7:38 within angle brackets, and close the curly brackets. Run the search to find only those places where the word is within a section tagged as John 7:38. To constrain it even further to just include relevant commentaries and not biblical text or other resources, use the collection of John commentaries that you made in the first video. To do this, click All Resources, enter John in the Find box to filter on that term, and click the Commentaries on John collection. You can now review these articles, confident that they will be discussing this particular word in the context of your study. Many more details on search capabilities and options are available in the Logos help file, and it is well worth exploring and experimenting with these to enable you to build powerful, flexible, and focused searches to enhance your study. This video has shown some of the search capabilities of Logos and how valuable they can be. They provide the ability to search thousands of resources for words, phrases, or various tags very quickly and enable you to focus down on precisely what you are studying. The next video in this series will focus particularly on morphological searching, showing how this can identify particular forms of words.